Hello everyone and welcome to the another video tutorial of channel Digitoners. Now in this video today we are going to learn how to make the social media buttons on our web page or website. So we have two types of social media buttons that we are going to learn to create. Number one is this one that is visible. So you can make this type of social media buttons on your website or web page. Another is this one, that is a hovering effect. So it is up to you which social media buttons or icons you want to add on your website. So we will learn how to create this type of social media buttons using HTML and CSS. So let's start with the video tutorial. So first, what we need to do, we need to open our Sublime text editor. Fine. And in the Sublime text editor, what we need to create a file first. We are using doc type, that is HTML. Then HTML tag, opening and closing of HTML tag. Now what I'm doing, let me save this file first, because then only the codes will come automatically. So I'm saving this file on desktop and I'm creating a new folder, social media icons. I'm saving this file with social.html. Fine. So we have added the extension also, social.html. That is the name of our file. So we have saved this file. Okay. Now after this HTML, we require a head tag. Then in the head tag, we require a title. And in title, we will mention the title of our web page. So I'm mentioning here like social media buttons. Fine. So I'm adding here social media buttons title. Then we require a link that we need to link a CSS file. Although we have not created the CSS file as of now, so we will write the name later on. Then again, we require a link. Now here, what we require, we need to link an external website. The name of the website is Font Awesome, because for social media, we require some icons. So that for that part, we will use an external website, Font Awesome. Font Awesome CDN. Fine. You please open this website, Font Awesome CDN. There you will get a file this type. So you require to copy down this CSS part and paste it here, using in the href part. Okay. Then after that, after this part, what you require to do, that is you will close the head section and then we will open the body tag. Fine. Now here the main work start. Now what we need to do here, that is first we will create a div tag. We will use the div tag, division tag, and in div we will mention a class. The name of the class we can give any. I am giving it as a name, main. Then again we will create another div and we will create another class and I am giving it a name as sub. Now in this class we will create a UL tag we will use, and inside this UL tag we will create li link. Now suppose we want to make, how many icons we want to make? Suppose we want to make 4, 5 or 6 icons, social media buttons. So for that we require another external website, that is Font Awesome Icons. So you open this website, Font Awesome Icons, and here there are n number of icons you can use. Fine. So what I'm doing as of now, suppose we want to create 5 social media buttons. It is up to you how many social media buttons you want to create. I'm creating 5. So this particular piece of text I'm copying down and pasting 5 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Clear? Now here what we need to do, we need to add a class that is from Font Awesome. So suppose first is our Facebook. Okay, so Facebook official we require. Then another we require Twitter. Twitter we have opened. Then Instagram, so we have opened Instagram. YouTube, we'll open YouTube also. And then suppose LinkedIn, then we open LinkedIn. So it is up to you which all icons, which all social media you want. Okay, now I have opened this Facebook. Now what we need to do, we need to copy down this particular piece of text from this website and insert it between the opening and closing of li tag. Fine. Same way for Twitter, we will copy down this particular piece of text and we will paste it between the opening and closing of li tag. Then again for Instagram, we will copy down this particular piece of text and paste it between the opening and closing of li. Then same for YouTube. And same with LinkedIn. Fine. So what we have done, we have copy pasted all the font icons that we require here. And this is just the HTML part. We have finished with the HTML part. Let me save it. And here it is. Now we will try to run this. Now see, all the pages, all the icons which we have added, those are visible here. Now we want to decorate it. Okay, we want to decorate it. For that we require another sheet, that is CSS. So we'll create another sheet, that is CSS. And for CSS body, because we want to modify the body part, first I'm saving this file as style1.css. Okay, I have saved this file using style1.css. Now what we need to do here, first we will write down the font family, which font we want. So I'm using here Source Sans Pro. Fine. Then we require a background. Background URL. We require a background, so let me just add a image. I'm using this. The name of the image is back4.png. So we'll write here back4.png. So this way we have added the background image. Then background position, that is center. and background size, that is cover. Fine. Okay, I think we have not added that style sheet in our file. We'll go to here, href, where we have reference style1.css. We have added the style sheet. We have linked our style sheet with the HTML and see. The background image has come. There is some problem. Background position, center, background size, cover. Fine. Now what we need to do next, we need to decorate these icons. So for these icons, what we need to do first, we will decorate the li, because every icon is there inside the li tag. So we will use li here, li list item, then list style none, and margin we'll use 10 pixels and 20 pixels. Then display we'll use inline block. Fine, let's see. Fine, we have made this appear as a flex type. After this, font size 20 pixels. Font size we are using to increase it, to increase the size of these. Then padding. Padding means the distance between each of the icon. 20 pixel, 20 pixel. Color, I'm using #FFF. Let's see what all changes it's there. Now I've changed the color of the icons and there is a gap between each and every icon. Now after color, we require to give a border. Border we will give as 2 pixels solid and #FFF white color. Okay, so we have given a border of 2 pixels and it's a solid and color is white. See, fine. Then border radius we want to give. Border radius I have given 50%, and after this, what is border radius? This one. We have moved it at a circle in shape. Fine. We have customized the border radius. It is up to you. Suppose you are giving it that as 20%. So it will be like this. So it is up to you. Fine. How you want to create it. If you want to giving it 80%, then it will be like this. Complete circle. Fine. Then after border radius, one more thing is there, that is transition effect. Transition means that a hovering effect, 0.5 second we are giving. Fine. So this will work when we add on the hover effect. So after this li, we need to write the code for the main class, that is, because these li's are there under the class sub. We'll write the code for sub dot sub, because it is a class, so we'll require dot sub. If it is not a class, it is a tag, then we will write like li we have mentioned, the name of the tag. Now in sub class, that is position absolute. When we try to make the position absolute, it will be like this. Now we will like to fix it on the page to wherever we want. Suppose top I have given as 45% top the margin will be 45%. From left the margin will be like 25%, and okay, transform, then transform, translate. Translate means the hovering effect. It will be minus 53% and minus 50%. Saving it, let's see what happened. Fine, these icons has been arranged in a particular manner, means they are coming. So I need to increase this size, left margin I'm making is at 45, so that it can come at the center. I think this is more, 40%. Means you need to arrange it according to the size of your padding. 20 20, the padding I think we need to increase 30 and 30. Well, that is not working fine. It's getting the okay. Okay, fine. This is can be okay. Now next is that we need to give it a hover effect. So what for hover? Because every item is there inside li, the li was hover, and then curly braces, color, which color we want. So suppose I am giving it as hash 29 29 29, that is a black color. Then border I am giving it as 2 pixels, solid hash 29 29 29, the same we have used above, and transition that is 0.5 seconds. Fine, we have given this transition effect 0.5 second. Let us see what comes. Now see, when we hover this, these are changing. When we are making, these are changing. Fine. So this is the first type, that how we can create the social media icons on our website. Fine. Now we will learn the second part, that is the aligning the social media icons on the left side or on the right side, and in a different loop. So first one we have finished. Now we are going to learn the second part, the second web page. So for this, what I am doing, I am just creating another file, and for that I am writing another code, that is doctype html. Fine. Then we will open HTML tag and HTML close. Sorry. Let me save it. Social2.html. Saved. Fine. Now in this HTML, we will like to link head, we'll give a head tag. Inside the head we will give the title, and title I am giving fixed social media icons. So title I have given. Then we will link the reference, the style sheet we have not created yet, but we will link it later. Now here what we need to do, we need to add a script, JavaScript. Okay, we need to add a JavaScript. For that script I'm using a script src source is equals to https://kit.fontawesome.com/a076d0539.js. Fine. So we have added a JavaScript here. Then after the head, we need to create a body tag. Inside the body, I'm creating a nav because that will be treated as a navigation bar that will be fixed on the left side. And inside that nav, I'm creating a UL. Fine. Now inside this UL, we'll create li, that is list item. And inside that list item, we'll create another tag that is anchor. href equals to hash. Hash is used for section linking. Fine. Hash is used for section linking. Now inside this, what we need to do, like here, in this, we have added these class, so we'll edit these class again. These font awesome tags, again, we will add here. And now what I'm doing, I'm copying down these line and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. What I'm doing, again, we need to make 5 tags. I'm copying it down and arranging them in a sequence. Now I need to change the code, that is for Twitter, I need to add on this. So I'm copying down and pasting it here. Then for Instagram, again, I'm copying down this and pasting it here. For YouTube, and last is for LinkedIn. Fine. So we have used every particular task. Now we have finished with the part. Now let us run this file also. Social 2. Now see here. Fine. Although the icons are not visible. Let me see if there is some error. kit.awesome.com a076d0539.js. Script is also okay. Let me add HTML, language equals to English, EN stands for English, and directly stand for LTR. And inside the head tag, we'll add meta tag, meta character UTF-8. Now we will make a CSS part for this. Now for your CSS, we need to import some Google APIs. So what we will write here, equal at the rate import, and let me save this file first. So I'm saving it with a name that is style 2.css, and let me call this style sheet here style 2.css. okay, so @ import, then URL, https://fonts.googleapis.com/css?family=. Montserrat :600, that is the size, and display :swap and fine. So this is the file you have to import in your CSS. Google fonts.googleapis.com/css?family=. Then 600 is the text size and display :swap. Once you've done this, now we will write the CSS code. We'll start asterisk. Asterisk means for complete web page. Margin is 0, padding 0, list style none, text decoration none, and box sizing border box. Fine. We have arranged this. Now we'll use for body, we'll write the code for body tag, font family. The font family we have already, that is MONT Montserrat, then comma sans serif. Fine. Then background URL back4.png, the same. Then background position center, and background size cover. Fine. Height 100 bh. So we have added the background. Then we will write the code for navigation, that is the main tag. For navigation, what I'm doing, let me just move it further. Okay. Now for navigation, we need to place it. So we'll require position. We will keep it as fixed because we don't want that it will scroll. Width 70 pixels. Then margin top 150 pixels. Transition, it should be all 0.3 second linear. Fine. Then box shadow, will require box shadow 2 pixels, then 2 pixels, 8 pixels, and 8 pixels, then RGBA color 228, will come as 0, 2280 RGB color, that is 0, 0, 0, 0.4. So now they have come into this part. Now next we move to the LI. As LI is inside the nav, so we will write nav LI, then height 60 pixels and position relative. We have increased the size. Now anchor tag will be used, as anchor is there inside the LI. So we'll write here LI. First we will write nav LI A color white, then display block height 100%, width 100%, then line height, it should be same as 60 pixel as the above one, padding left because we are aligning at the left side, 25%. Then after padding, border bottom, I'm using at 1 pixel solid, RGBA, then we need to give a color code that will give the same as 0.4. Fine, and then transition all 0.3 second linear. Now they have divided into different parts, different boxes. Fine. Now after this, as we have 1, 2, 3, let me just remove these things, hidden true, they are getting disturbed because of this. We don't want to use this in the HTML file. Fine. Class equals to fab, will require a new class, that is fab fa Facebook, and in Facebook we require this f fit Twitter, Instagram, LinkedIn / in fa / LinkedIn / -in that we need to do. And these icons, Social 2, okay, fine. Then again we need to make the decoration part for that child items. So we have a nav li nth child first, that is for first social media icon, and that will be on the anchor tag. Fine. So what we have used, nav, that is the main part, that is the navigation bar. Then inside nav we have li, and inside ni we have a child, that is the social media icon on the first part. So we will require here, that is background. And we write a color code here, that is hash 4267B2. Fine. We have used a color code here. Now what I am doing, the items which I have, fine, so I am copying it and pasting it for every social media icons. So we have 5 social media icons here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. One is already there, 2, 3, 4, 5. What we need to do, we need to change this number from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and we need to change the background color also. For second, I am using 1DA1F2. For third, I am using E1306C. For fourth, I am using #2867B2. And for fifth, I am using #333. This is the social media buttons. They are coming. Okay. Now next to it, we need to modify another items in our CSS part, that is nav, then li, a, and I, the tag, position, absolute, top, 17 pixels, then left 20 pixels, font size 27 pixels, then UL LI, sorry, A/hover, fine. Z index, we'll use a property as 1 because we want it to appear on the top. Width of this is 200 pixel, and border bottom, that is 1 pixel solid, RGBA bracket 0, 0, 0, 0.5, and box shadow, that is 0 (0)(1px) RGBA bracket 0, 0, 0.3. Fine. And last, we need to write for UL bracket LI, UL LI over A. Then padding left, should be 30%, and display block. They are coming now in this way. Now what we require to write some names here, like they are bringing up, so we require to write some names here. So what we will do in our HTML file, what we need to add, we need to add a span. We'll add a span here, span tag, and here we will write Facebook, and I'm copying down this span and pasting it here. So Facebook, then Twitter, Instagram, and this is your YouTube and LinkedIn. We have given a name to our particular parts. Facebook, Twitter. Okay, so as you have seen that we have added one more particular social media button, that is a GitHub. Now what we changes we need to make in our CSS is that as we have added, till now we have added the five elements. So what we will do, we'll copy down this and paste it for the sixth element that we have just added. Fine. Now when we are adding this sixth element, we need to just change the background color. So I am changing its background color as ash double F 4x0. Fine. Clear? Fine. Now we have added a span tag also in the HTML part. So we need to write the code for that span also. So I'm writing here only ULLIA span. Fine. Display none. Let me go to display none. Then font weight, that has to be bold. Then letter spacing 1 pixel, and text transformation, that is uppercase. Fine, we have transformed the text in this uppercase. So li hover we have written, and we have written this case also. So what next we require, that is, let me just refresh it. Okay, now the names are not visible, the names which we have written in the span part, those names are not visible. So for that, what we need to do, we need to add another part, that is when we do hover on UL LI colon hover a span. So padding left, that is to be 30%, and display, that has to be block. Let us see. Now see, the names are there. Fine. So students and everyone, so this is our second part of the video in which we have learned how to create the social media icons or buttons that remain fixed. If you browse this, if you scroll this page also, this particular piece of section, that is the social media icon, it will remain fixed here. It will not get scrolled along with the pages if you are scrolling. So if you want to link any of the particular account with these buttons, so the user, when the user will click on this particular part, so it will be redirected to a particular web page or website. So what you can do, wherever you have written hash, okay, like suppose YouTube, so you have to write the address of the YouTube. So suppose I'm opening, let me open this YouTube channel, and DigiTonus. Okay, so this is the channel link for my, what I need to do, I need to write here, that is this particular piece of text, and save it. Once you have written, now what you have given a particular redirection. When the user will click on it, what will happen? The user will be redirected to the particular channel or the link whatsoever you have given. So if you want to link any of your web page, suppose you want to link your Facebook account, so instead of this hash, you can give the link to the proper part. Suppose let me open this Control C. So what I'm doing, as soon as the user will click on this particular Facebook account, so that particular page will get opened. Okay. That particular page will get open. I have closed that part, social media. Okay, so on Facebook, we have also linked a Facebook website. So when the user will click on this, the user will be redirected to another web page or website. So I hope you have enjoyed this video tutorial, and you also have learned how to create the social media icons using HTML and CSS. So if you like the video, if you like the video tutorial, and if you have learned something, then please do click on the like button. Share the video with your friends and family members, and please don't forget to subscribe the channel and hit the bell icon for latest updates. So thank you everyone. Thank you all.